After suffering its first conference loss to Purdue Fort Wayne, the South Dakota State men have earned back-to-back wins and look for their third straight W as the Jacks and Oral Roberts squared off at Frost Arena. Opening half, Skyler Flatten comes up with the steal, and he's going to come in all alone, rise up, and throw down the two-handed jam. So he finished with 15 points, Jacks up by three. Next SDSU possession, they'll feed Mike Dom in the post. He'll look around, take a dribble, rise up, and get the bucket. After combining for 14 points his last two games, Dom dropped a game-high 37 in this one. More from the Jacks. Tevin King gets it up to David Jenkins Jr. He'll find the bottom of the net on the step-back three. He added 15, and SDSU earns its third straight win, 84-65. The Jackrabbit women also cross paths with Oral Roberts in Brookings. Opening possession of the game, Maya Sellin gets the elbow, pulls up, and gets a friendly bounce for the bucket. She had a game-high 19 points. Later, Macy Miller is going to with a long pass up to Maddie Giebert in the corner. She'll hit nothing but net for three of her 14 points as the Jacks go up three. Skip ahead to the second quarter, Giebert leading the fast break. She'll dump off to Peyton Burkhardt, and the freshman puts away two of her 9 points as SDSU earns its second straight win, 68-55. The USD women welcome Purdue Fort Wayne to Vermilion. Opening quarter, Coyotes down 7. Kira Duffy gets the ball. She'll weave her way around the Fort Wayne defense and then get the left-handed shot to drop for two of her 15 points. USD trails 13-8. Later in the quarter, Duffy drives and kicks to Liv Corngable in the corner. She splashes in three of her 8 points as USD grabs its first lead of the game, 15-12. Second quarter, Coyotes trailing by a pair. Chloe Lamb gives to Hannah Shervin. She'll take it to the hole and lay in two of her game-high 21 points. After a slow start, USD pulls away for the 69-51 victory. The Augie men hosted Winona State in an NSIC matchup. Augie trailed by 20 at the break, trying to come back. A.J. Plitzowitz shot is no good. Michael Schaefer grabs the board, kicks out to Jamison Bryan, who connects for three of his 13. Vikings within 15, but Winona never let it get to within single digits. Caleb Wagner takes his man off the dribble and lays in two of his 16 points as Winona State knocks off Augie 87-67. The Augustana women hosted conference rival Winona State. In the second quarter, it's Augustana's Lindsay Prosser dishing to Abby Hora, who buries the triple from the top of the key. The Viberg native added 20 points. Augustana leads 14-9. Later in the second, it's Winona's Gabby Dowd finding Julia Siloway in the corner. She shreds the net for three of her team-high 11 points, cutting Augustana's lead to 2. More from the home team as Lindsay Prosser drives to the baseline, spins, and nails the two-point jumper. The senior led all players with 22 points. Augustana gets their second straight win, defeating Winona State 75-65. DeSmit and Corsica Stickney met in a top-five showdown at the Hanson Classic. Late first quarter, Corsica Stickney senior Courtney Menning dishes to Avery Broughton, who cashes in the long three. The eighth grader had a game-high 20 points. Jaguars lead 13-9. Ahead to the second quarter, Corsica Stickney gets out in transition as Menning bounces to Rachel Gerlach. She'll make a move and bank in two of her 9 points as the Jaguars extend their lead to 12. Later in the quarter, DeSmit's Autumn Wilkinson dishes to Raina Beck, who splashes home three of her 5 points to cut the lead to 9. But Corsica Stickney stays unbeaten with a 56-40 win over DeSmit. The top-ranked Lennox girls face number 2, St. Thomas More. Late in the fourth quarter, St. Thomas More's Haley Timmer fires a cross-court pass to Marin Duffy. She'll shred the net at the buzzer to tie the game at 49 and send it to OT. On the first play of overtime, Lennox's Rihanna Philippi dishes to Isabel Einen, who connects for three of her 7 points. Lennox leads 52-49. Later in the period, Lennox will feed Madison Vlaschin. She'll bank in two of her game-high 20 points, and Lennox escapes Mitchell with a 61-57 overtime win over St. Thomas More. The Stampede looked for their third straight win as they hosted Sioux City. On the power play, Anthony Romano gives to Max Crozier. He'll feed Ethan Phillips, who finishes off the tic-tac-toe play with a one-timer for the goal as the Herd grab the 1-0 lead. Later in the first, Sioux Falls turns it over and Sioux City makes them pay as Ian Malcolmson beats Alec Calvaruso with the wrister as the Musketeers even the game up at 1. Later in the first, Herd back on the attack. Andre Lee feeds Brian Chambers out front, but Jake Sabell sticks the paddle out for the save. Game tied at 1 after 1. Sioux Falls would go on to pick up the 4-3 victory.